Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we're inside of Affinity Designer and I want to show you how you can kind of make this little effect you've got in front of you, as well as save it into assets and why you may want to do that. So first we'll begin just by talking about the effect that we got here, and you can see it just kind of looks like a sticker that folds over on itself, and you can do this with various different shapes and put your corners anywhere around it that you like. So we'll first begin by drawing one of these so you guys can see how it comes together. I'm going to do that on a brand new canvas. On this design, I think I'm going to go for another kind of circle. So we'll start by grabbing the ellipse tool and just drag that out to any size that you like. If you hold down shift on your keyboard, that'll keep your proportions perfect. And I'm just going to center that into the middle of the page. Just like that. At this point, you can color this any color you like. It's entirely up to you. For me, in my styles down here, I've got some presets that I've made, such as YouTube, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc. And I think for this design, we'll go with the Twitter. So I'm just going to click on that to give me that gradient. And quickly, for those of you who don't know what styles are, what they're used for, generally it's just a way of you creating a gradient. For instance, I just drag out another shape quickly and I just put a fill on there. And I just start making the gradient out of these, giving it some random colors. Just like that. If I want to now save this as a style so I can apply it to other shapes later on down the line, all I've got to do is come up here to edit on the top menu, come down to where it says create style. Once you tap on that, you can see it's now available down here in our styles menu, and we can rename that by right clicking and renaming, and you can delete it if you don't want it. Then it is just a case of tapping on your original shape that you just had, such as that round one we just did, and applying that style. So you can see how quick and easy and efficient that is. And it's always worth doing these kind of effects so you can come back to these later on and apply them again. So I'm just going to delete that because I don't need to keep that. And I'm just going to reapply this Twitter one to this circle. And we'll carry on at this point. And what I'm going to do next is turn the stroke off because I don't want that on this shape. Then I need to find my assets menu. And to find that, we're going to go up to view. We're going to go down to studio and we're just going to check the assets right there. And now I've got this menu over here with my assets in here. And these are just a few social media icons I downloaded off the internet and I imported. Okay, so as we're going to make this Twitter, we're going to just drag the Twitter one in. And then we're going to resize that to a size that we're happy with and just center that in the middle. And that will do perfectly fine. I'm going to make a copy of this outer circle with Command or Control C, Command and Control V to paste. I'm going to hold down Command and Shift together to bring this in itself, or Command and Control together. And just going to bring that down to around there. And I'm going to turn off the fill on that and I'm going to give it a stroke of white. Then I'm going to come down to my stroke menu and I'm going to resize that to make it a little bit of a bigger line. So probably around 30 points will be fine. And you can have different effects here. You can come in here and have the dotted line effect if you want, rather than having a straight line. And just change the settings in here to the kind of thing that you're going for. I kind of think I like the way that one just looks, so I think I'll stick with this for a minute. Okay, so now we've done this, I've got this Twitter inside of a group and I don't really want it in there, so I'm going to drag that out and just delete that empty group. And we're going to need to do that if you want to cut these two pieces out of this bit. But for now, we'll just continue with this. So if we just select this background that we've already got, and what we need to do now is come up to the top menu bar. We want to convert this to curves. So once we turn on that, it's going to create that into a custom made shape. Then we have the option to manipulate that using the node tool over here on the left hand side, that little white triangle. So once you select that node tool, we've just got to come in here and decide roughly where we want this crease to be and which angle you want it to come at. So I think if we just come from this angle on this one, and I'm going to put a point around there and maybe just use that one that we've already got over there. So once you've already got this one selected blue, if you come over and you hold down shift and select on that one as well, that's going to highlight that one too. Then we just need to come up to the top menu bar where we've got this action menu. And then we're going to choose this break curve. And once you hit that break curve, if we look over in the layers menu, you can see we've now got this in two different pieces. And what we need to do with this piece that we just cut is we've got to rotate it. So if we come over and grab our move tool, and then we're just going to rotate this all the way around to the opposite direction. And if you hold down shift, it will lock that in perfectly to those 15 degree rotation points. And then we just got to move that and let that snap into place just like that. And then we're going to move this to the top of the layers. So now that is covering it. But just for now, we're going to turn this off. as we've just got a couple more things to take care of, and that is the Twitter logo and the ellipse. If I just change the color of this now, you can see that is outside of this background shape. So if we come to turn this back on, once we come to finish it, it's not going to look right. We need to actually put this one inside of this shape underneath it. So if I just turn that back off again, and the way we're going to do that is just simply select the Twitter logo. We're going to pull it down till we've got this big blue bar here. Then we're going to drag it over to the right till that shrinks. And then we're just going to drop that just like that. And then what happens here is that this background image becomes a clipping mask for the Twitter logo, meaning that anything inside of here can no longer go outside of the boundaries. So then it's just a case of also dragging this one in now underneath that. And if you change the color of that as well, you can see what's going on. That's on the fill. So I'm just going to undo that and change the stroke color. So you can see how that works. So I'm just going to put these back to white for now and change that back to the fill. And I'll turn this one back on. And all we want to do now is just change the color of this one. So if we go over and grab the fill tool again and we just drag from the back to the front. And we're going to change this front color here to a light gray. Somewhere around there, we're going to change the back color to a darker gray. Something like that. And in the middle here, we create another point and we're going to make that white. And then it gives us this nice white line going straight across there, which will give it that more kind of realistic fold over effect. And what we want to do now is we're just going to put a drop shadow on this. And we'll do that by coming down to the effects and choosing outer shadow. And what we want to do now is make sure that we are focusing the shadow on the left hand side here, as if we leave it over here on the angle, it's going to be slightly sticking out of this side and then that'll ruin the design. So we just want to change the angle over to the left. So we know that the shadow is sitting on this side of the image, and then we've just got to change the radius and the offset to make that a little bit smaller. Just bring that in and kind of make it look a little bit more realistic. Something like that is fine. And if we just click off this now, you can see how it all comes together. And finally, if you wanted to, you can bend this a little bit more just by selecting your node tool up here on the left hand side and just putting in a couple of points. So one there and maybe one here, put one in the middle, and then you just start dragging this into a position that you're happy with. Adjust these handles to give it kind of more of a folded effect that you may be going for. It's a case of having to play around with that and seeing what you like. And then you can see how that kind of comes together. So with that being complete, all we want to do now is just group all these by selecting the top one, holding down shift, select the bottom one, and just command G to group or control G. And then we can come in and resize this. But before you make this smaller, I'm just going to click back in here because it's something that I may not have said before. If you click on your ellipse down here and you come over to your stroke menu, we've got this option down here that says scale with object, and we need to make sure that this is turned on. If we don't make sure this is turned on, this is what's going to happen when we reshrink this. You can see what's going on, that it's getting smaller, but these boxes are staying the same size. So I'm just going to undo that. And if we come ahead and turn on the scale with object, that will fix that problem. So once we go to resize it again, it will shrink with the item and it will always readjust itself to whatever size you decide to have this. So now this is complete. We can just rename this Twitter. Then we can talk about adding this to our assets. So if you haven't already got the assets window open here, just head up to your view menu on the top, go down the studio and make sure you've got assets checked. And once we are inside of here, what we need to do first is we're going to come up to this little section up here where we've got the four lines and a little triangle, and we're going to create a new category. And once we've done that, you can see we've got an empty field here, and all we've got to do is select our item we just created and just drag that in and let it go. And now this is forever stored in here until you go and delete it. But what we're going to do first is come back to where we just created a new category and we're going to rename this. So you can call this socials. And all we've got to do now is we can just delete this. At any point you ever want to use this again, we could just drag it straight from there. And if we come over to our layers, you can see that we still have all the original files inside of here that we worked with. So essentially, you've still got the entire project, but you saved it into assets, which is going to work out so much better in the long run if you come to make hundreds of these different kind of graphics. So if I just go ahead and just delete this one, I'm just going to import the ones that I've already made, which is this Facebook and this YouTube one. So I can just grab the YouTube and just drag that over as well, drop that in, do the same with the Facebook. And I can just delete both of these and then just drag them back in again if I need them. However, there is one thing to note when it comes to using assets. You always want to make sure that things are inside of a group when you come to drag it in here. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to access it the way we got it here. And I'm just going to quickly demonstrate what I mean by that. So if I just drag this one out and this one out, and we'll just delete that for a moment. If I now select these, because it's not in a group, I've got to select them individually and drag this over and drop it in. You can see what's happened here is it now gives us this graphic in all individual pieces. And that's obviously not what we want to do. So if I just delete that now and I drag this in, we've got to start bringing it all in individually and building it all back together, which obviously isn't recommended. So just always make sure you save it as a group and then bring it over in the group itself. You can always come back and access everything inside of there, just like that. And of course, if you ever want to save these and import these to another computer, you can do that just by coming up to the menu just up here. And instead of creating a new category or renaming it, we just want to export it. Same as if you're bringing it into your new computer, you just import it and find it on your hard drive. And it is as simple as that. They'll always be in here until you manually delete them just by either right clicking on this and deleting that. Or you can come back up in here and you can delete the entire category, which will be our socials category. So I'm just going to close the assets now because I no longer need it. And I just recenter that. So there is my little video on creating assets and why you may want to do that and how to do this little effect that I just showed you too. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up as it really helps with the YouTube algorithm and helps other people find my content. And of course, if you haven't already, then please hit that subscribe button and check out all my other videos as well as all my future releases. If any of you are new to Affinity Designer, I've just recently uploaded a crash course on Affinity Designer, which will teach you all the basics to get you started. If you want to go ahead and check that out, I will add that in the top right hand corner now. But I hope you enjoy the rest of your day and I will see you in the next video.